You know what, man? Fuck it. Let's do it. Hey, it's Mike Petersen. I'm an Australian natural bodybuilder, a retired pro wrestler, where I enjoyed chasing that dream around the globe for the better part of my 20s, and now full-time coach and founder at the NPT Natty Gainz Academy, which is my online coaching program and movement, where I teach lads in their 20s, mostly, some are in their 30s, how to build supernatural, above-average, head-turning, world-class physiques, and how to do it naturally. Now, after months of contemplation, I've decided that I am going to compete again in this season, which is season B at the ICN and INBA Natural Nationals, which are the Australian contests. Now, last year, after I won the Mr Australia in my height category, I would have sworn black and blue that I wasn't competing again. Bodybuilding is gay. It is a who can starve themselves longer contest. You don't need to prove it anymore. You've won three of these now. There's not a chance in hell I'm doing it. But in the same breath, last season, as much as I did win my height category, I placed second in the overall. Binge eating, Uber Eats, and business-related stress got the better of me, and I didn't arrive on the day my best. And that burns my ass. I'm a competitor by heart, and you can't take the competitor out of me, or at least I won't yet. So I'm deciding that I'm going to go back, and I'm going to finish the unfinished business that I left on the plate last year. It wasn't until about 4 weeks ago that I decided that I was going to do this. I've been dieting for the last 12 weeks to come in condition for some marketing for the business, and I thought, why not? I'm hungry, I'm competitive, the drive is still there. It's also a good chance for me to use this as a cornerstone to launch this YouTube channel, starting off with the exclusive series, The Road to the Natty Mr Australia, where I'm going to give you guys a behind the scenes, no BS, as real as it gets look into everything that it takes to get on stage and compete at a national level as a natural bodybuilder. I'm going to be showing you guys the training system that I use to get on stage as big as possible, the nutrition system that I use, the supplements, why I take them and how they work, the mindset side of it, and of course, how I optimize my recovery outside of the gym. We'll be dropping a weekly episode, so make sure that you subscribe and click the notifications bell to stay up to date. And finally, yes, I am 100% natty. I've been training for close to 20 years. I'm 5'10" and weigh anywhere from 85 kilos on stage to 96 kilos in the off season, which is around 190 to 210 pounds, if you go by that metric scale. I got into bodybuilding initially at around 14. I was first to hit puberty in my class, so my voice was breaking. The high pitch was up and down early on. Had the awkward mustache hairs before anyone else. And lacked confidence. Like most people, I believe, that get into the gym, it's because they lack confidence. At that time, I tuned into my first episode of WWE Raw, and I saw The Rock. And that was it for me. His confidence, his charisma, his physique, it's everything I thought that I wanted. So naturally, I wanted to look like him. I started lifting in Dad's rumpus room. I outgrew that by my 16th birthday. All I wanted was a gym membership, which I got, and I was plugging away in there. And I think subconsciously, one of the main reasons why I've stayed natural the entire time and not been tempted to go down that other path is because I got great results early on. So I never thought that I needed it. I thought that it was for cheats. I thought that it was people that wanted a shortcut. They wanted an instant fix. And in my mind, I didn't need that because I already had great results. I was bench pressing 120 kilos by year 12. So that was one of the reasons that I've decided to stay natural. The other one is a family member of mine got tied up in a little bit of recreational drug use in university, and as a result has developed a mental condition and is medicated. And so for me, very early on, drugs was just, it was almost a religious no-go zone. It's black and white for me. It's not even a decision. I've never been tempted. People have said to me, man, like with your genetics and your work ethic, if you got on the gear, you'd be bigger than Chris Bumstead. You'd be able to compete on an IFBB stage and do the Olympia. And for me, I've never been interested in it. I've had enough success early on. And when I took it seriously in my 20s, I was able to compete in natural bodybuilding contests and won and did quite well. You know, almost made it in the WWE. I tried out a few times and almost made it there without it. So I've never really needed it. It's almost like I compare it to a religion. You know, if you've got someone that is a mad Christian, trying to get them to convert to Islam, it's not even... it's not even a conversation. It doesn't even register as an option. And now with the online space, how it is, it gives me the chance to be excited about leading this movement, about leading this Natty Gainz movement and teaching young guys who want to do it in a healthy manner and want to look like the action heroes they see in the movies that, hey, you can do this naturally. You don't have to get on the gear, on the SARMs, you don't have to do any of that stuff if you're able to approach it correctly. And that's exactly what this channel and this series is all about. It's about leading by example and showing anybody out there who's interested in doing it naturally that you can do it. There are certain methods and certain things that you need to do, but it's possible. Thanks for watching. And again, if you're interested, make sure you subscribe and turn the notifications bell on, and I'll see you along the way.